Hello everyone, RT here from Digital Flash Fire, and I was here leveling and I realized that there's somebody new here, so I wanted to catch who this was. Who are you?
You're an unkindled, aren't you?
I am.
I am Cirrus of the Sunless Realm.
Cirrus.
Former servant of the divinity.
Right on. Nice
duty
to meet you, Cirrus.
But one's duty is a solitary affair. I doubt we've much to gain from fraternization.
Oh, she's not that interested.
Blessing of the moon upon your journey.
Yeah, right on.
I doubt we've much to blessing of the moon.
Oh, well, that was sort of anticlimactic. I thought that she would have more to say. And I also remember that there's a dude up here that I've seen like 30 times, and I have never tried to talk to. He's like sitting in the throne. Will you just... where's your legs?
All that unkindled, and a seeker of lords.
I am.
I am Ludlith of Corland.
Ludlith, hello.
Look not in bewilderment as I say. I linked the fire long ago, becoming the Lord of Cinder.
Ah, I did that
if
once.
If substantiation be thy want,
set thine eyes
upon my charred corpse.
Wow.
This sad cadaver. No need to be coy. Have a closer look.
No, you know what, Ludlith? I think I'm good. I think I'm okay. Oh, this is who I give the transposing thing to. Let's see what else he has to say.
This might pique thine interest.
Ooh.
Before I was a Lord of Cinder, I was a student of transposition, the process of extracting and coalescing the essence of a soul, a forbidden art that once left a foul stain upon Corland's honor. Tis an art that grants...
Man, he is a chatty little cadaver, isn't he?
Most transposing...
Ugh, crossing all manner of curse.
If thou happenst upon a transposer,
bring it to me, quick. You know what? I've actually got one for you right here.
Oh?
Oh?
Like it is a transposing kiln in thy possession.
Uh-huh.
Better days, but... it shall suffice.
Methinks it will.
Now.
A twisted soul.
With transposition is the art of extracting and
yep.
transposing a
twisted,
twisted
soul.
Soul.
Yep.
Thy purpose is to seek lords and slay them.
Okay, what's transposition? Oh. Okay. So, I killed the rotted great wood, and I can either use its soul to give me a whole bunch of souls, or he can turn it into something special. So, what is this? Can I just have this, please? Okay. So he can turn it into this greatsword, the Hollow Slayer greatsword. Used for a lifetime by a masked knight, harbors the fears that lurk within the minds of hollows. It is particularly effective against them, bestowed with proper mirror night long ago. Two-hand special sword, okay. This is the... Who's... Soul of a demon I don't have. I do have, Vort's... Vort's Great Hammer. Oh, I can get Vort's Great Hammer. 30 strength. I'm not using that anytime soon. The Outrider, the Boreal Knight. Weapon is imbued with frost and causes frostbite. Okay, frost accumulates in the body, causing frostbite, which saps one health, lowers absorption, and slows stamina recovery. Wow. Oh, I can make... Ooh, I can make a spear? I love spears! And it's got a poison effect on it. One of the curses that festered within the belly of the Great Wood, and a terrible weapon favored by... Earl Astor the Impaler. The spear is enwreathed with rotten, heavily poisonous meat. Defeating foes restores HP! Yeah! Okay. That's the one. That's the one we want. What do I need for this? Can you just make this for me? Okay, I want this. Yes. I want this. Demon's Fist? Seems pretty cool. Not interested. That's what I used Vort's soul for. That's okay. Oh, that's so cool. Bleed, damage, absorption. Let's get rid of the lowering attack thing. Bewitched ring that Pontiff Sylvan bestowed upon his knights recovers with successive attacks. Knights who peer into the black orb are lured into battles of death, transformed into frenzied beasts. No wonder the Pontiff only provides these rings to those dispatched to foreign lands. Spooky! Love it. And my sweet... Oh, that's right. I need... What do I have now? I have 18 dexterity. I need one more. And... I'm just so pumped. Okay. Gotta focus up. Gotta keep moving. Wow. We're only 5 minutes into this already. So, in our last episode, we had gotten to the halfway point. Literally called a halfway fortress. Where we met, Ezria? Ersa? And she was hanging out with her friend Horace, and they were talking about how there's a forest, and then a legion, and then a pontiff, and we are off and running. Okay, guys. Guys and gals. When I say guys, I mean everyone. It's, you know, we all grow up with colloquialisms. Colloquial? It's words that we use that aren't quite right. Oh! Hey, guys. Ooh. Yeah, you're gonna feel that. So these are just dudes with big sticks. Ow. Who also run right by you. God, there's a lot of them too. Is this just a big open area full of people with sticks? Is that what level design has come to these days? I guess I'll drop... Okay, those look like things. Maybe I won't drop down. Oh, let's see. I mean, there really are a lot of them, right? Yep, figured that was gonna happen. Get the heck out of there. You guys. Oh, you guys. Shit, do not die, please. Oh, man. I thought I was supposed to get health back with successive attacks. Maybe I am. Maybe it's just so little. Well, that was a hot mess. I'm gonna have to bring my faith up. I'm not getting a lot of heals. Can we do it? No, we can't. Okay. Dude and a big pup? Oh, wow. Always feels good to be able to charge somebody. Titanite shards. Okay. First of all, just take a look at this swamp. It's beautiful. The question is whether or not it's poisonous, which it doesn't look like it is. Cool. Hello? Do you see that massive crab back there? Right over my right shoulder? Holy shit. Okay, we'll get there. Okay, so these are guys. These are bugs. What do they do? Do I want to find out? I do want to find out. Oh. I don't like that. Alright. They're poison bugs. All they are. It's what they do. Not a big deal. There's a lack of things here. Alright, there's a door over there. Honestly, this is a huge area. I'm not really sure where to go first. Let's check the other side. I hear something. Get rid of the bugs. Titanite shard. I mean, they're not even really enemies at this point. You just kind of hit them for free souls, right? Ah. Okay. I guess that's how you do that. Ooh, You're a little poison there. Titanite shards are always good. Oh, I missed him. Didn't miss him that time. I wonder if I could sneak up on this guy. Yep, got him. Alright. So, what I'm guessing is there's a lot of guys to kill, but we're not going to spend a lot of time here. Because once I've gotten everything from this area, I'm just not going to come back to this area. So, it's worth doing a once-over. Look for shinies. These guys really haven't been dropping much. Oh, hey. Ow, that was unnecessary. Yeah, they really haven't been dropping anything, so it's not like I have to worry about... It's another mad soul thing. If I can sneak up. Oh, I can! Clears one of them. And that clears two of them. Okay. How bad is it gonna be if I fall into this? What is that over there? What's over there by the bonfire? Not one good way to find out. Estus shard, good. What are you? Oh, and I can target you, good. Oh. Okay. Well, that would be why they call it the Crucifixion Woods. Come on, come on, kill him. He's got a lot of health. Oh, come on. Come on, come on. Nope, nope, nope. Nope, nope, nope. That was a little messy. Maybe this one won't be so bad. Looks like he's only got like half his legs. Nope, he was just hanging out waiting for me. Okay. I had a weird moment while we were... I kind of stopped talking for a second, but I had a weird moment while we were having that last fight. This is starting to feel a lot like Bloodborne. It's starting to look a lot like Bloodborne. And I like Bloodborne. I really like Bloodborne. But if you wanted to make another Bloodborne game, then make another Bloodborne game. You know? Not an illusionary wall. God damn it. I'll take two. A lot of guys. Come on, you're not gonna hit me, it's fine. Calm down. Oh, I don't like shooting magic at me. It's just a weird shift, you know? I don't know. hang on. I got really just grim there for a second in my head. I'm gonna play it either way, because I love the game so far. It's really good. And I can tell that they've learned from their successes. I mean, Dark Souls 2 was not good. Not great. Commonly used generations of heretic sorcerers. I don't know. I suppose I might be a little bit of an old man. I want things the way they used to be, but I'm perfectly happy with this. You know what? I would go so far as to say Praise the rolling. I'm going to go ahead and say that I'm really enjoying this. And I like that it's a mixture of Dark Souls and Bloodborne. And I'm going to be progressive and awesome. And what is over here? Yep. Really? One short, huh? One short. Let's put the this guy back on for a little bit. See what kind of results we pull with this. Sneak around the back. Oh, there's a whole staircase up there. Okay, we'll come back to it. That was where we were. This is going somewhere. You're the one I want. Come here, come here, come here, come here, come here. Yes! Oh. I wanted a twinkling titanite shard. Yep. That was well planned. Oh yeah, they hate that. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Then this is our weapon of choice. Someone is yawning upstairs? Okay, we're on the other side. Giant crab's over there in the middle still. Warriors slumber ahead. I'm ready. I'm ready! Oh. You're just regular guys. Regular guys who I don't want to take on two at a time. Come on down, bud. There you go. Ha ha! It's about as classy as you can get that, I guess. I might have enough for another level up and I can start using that spear, but I don't want to break the momentum of exploring. Ugh. I love games that just let you explore. Don't go down. Oh, but there's a thing there. We must go down. Ring of Sacrifice. I think that's new. I don't think we have any of those yet. So a Ring of Sacrifice from the other games, if I'm wearing this and I die, I don't lose my souls and I go back to my bonfire. Mystical ring has created the sacrificial rite of Velka, goddess of sin. It's where we'll lose nothing upon death, but the ring itself breaks. So it's sort of a get out of jail free card. If you know you're going to die or something awful is going to happen to you, you throw it on really quick. And I was kind of expecting this ring to do a little bit more than it was doing. There's a shiny over there. Battle crab's coming for me. All right, come on, let's talk about this. Hey, come on, I don't want trouble. You don't want trouble. I mean, this is your swamp. it's your swamp. I don't need it. I'm just passing through. Yawn. Okay. Let's go check and see what this shiny is. Green blossom. And we can duck back in here. Ah, good. Gotta watch that. I'm really liking this sword. It's really fast. Really fast. Okay, good. Sorcerer, hood, robe, gloves, trousers. I am not a sorcerer, so that doesn't help me at all. And a sage ring. Ooh. Is somebody coming after me? What's all this noise I hear? Okay. Shortened spellcasting time. Commonly as crystal sages, shortened spellcasting time. Sorcerers of Farron's Abyss Watchers were known to be lonesome warriors who would only reply upon more pragmatic spells. Well, considering that my... Ah! I hate you so much! I just want there to be a hidden path so nobody thinks I'm crazy. K, considering that my heal spell is a miracle spell and not a sorcery, I don't think it's going to translate. So I'm not gonna use it. There's a shiny over there too, but we're starting to inch pretty close to that crab. And I haven't finished exploring here too. Oh, I didn't know this actually went somewhere. Alright, we'll get there. This definitely feels like the kind of area where you just wanna... Invaded by Watchdog of Farron Ludwig von something. Okay. Sounds like an NPC invasion. Let's get it! Where are you? Where are you? You coming for me? Take a look for him. Take a look for him. Where is he? Oh! Hey-o! Oh, okay. That seems normal. That seems normal. What is this? What's really going on right now? He's like floating around. Is this a glitch? I mean, I feel like I should be fighting him, but I can't see what he's doing. I have no idea. I don't even know how I landed that. One of the things that was a problem in the other games is that you have hackers that do stuff like this. So, if this is a computer player, I'm very surprised. If this is not a computer player, I believe it more. You know what? I'm just gonna die to him. I don't care. That was stupid. That was dumb. I mean, you can't see any of the animations. You can't tell what they're doing. That was stupid. That kind of shit pisses me off so much. Grass crest shield, very cool. Yep, I know you're a giant crab. I'm well aware of what's going on right now. Dark spirit, yellow finger, Heisel. What's really going on right now? I don't understand. I mean, I knew that this was gonna happen because of having an ember, but fuck, goddamn. Hyper aggressive, guys. Not really sure what I'm supposed to do here. And there's the guy. This is a mess. This is an absolute friggin' mess. Well. I didn't get my souls back. Nobody from the Blue Covenant came to help me, by the way, so I don't know what that shit was all about. Gonna have to talk to them about membership dues. Had a giant crab chasing me. Yep, I hear you. I don't know where this even is. Where was I? I was over there. Fallen Knight stuff. Alright, well, you know. A little sunny disposition isn't bad. All these guys are back, aren't they? Let me get up a level and dip back around. Onward for the sake of progress. Sorry, it's gonna happen. It's Dark Souls. It's totally cool. No reason to be salty about it. I mean, if they were maybe similarly geared to me, then that would be something. What is this? Metal shield fashioned in the form of a falcon with its wings outstretched. The golden falcon was the emblem of an ancient band of sellswords. Even to this day, many mercenaries remain who look upon it as a token of good fortune. Except that it is awful. Grass crest shield. Old medium shield of unknown origin. Slightly imbued with magic with slightly speed stamina recovery. God, 89% damage reduction? I mean, I like stamina recovery, but I'm just simply not interested, guys. Look, all I'm saying, my point here is that if I was being invaded by people who were similar level, who were similarly geared, I don't care what their reason for it is, but, you know, if you invade somebody else's world and just wreck them with super, like, high-end stuff like that, that's not fair to me, and it's not fun either. It's not fun at all. In fact, it's rather agitating. Go away. Just go away. Of course he's gonna heal. Why wouldn't he heal? Let's just get through this fight. Let's just get through this. And we can cry about it later. Cost me two stupid deaths. One more time. One more time. Just hit him one more time. Just hit him one more time. Okay. Oh. Now we're back to it. One-on-one. Don't kick me, you jerk. How can you move like that in that armor? That's ridiculous. These enemies are ridiculous. That's fine. Maybe this is the area where they're like, hey, get ready for PvP because it's coming. I mean, that would explain why we have regular enemies that attack like regular people do. Maybe it's one of those things. Exile Greatsword. Maybe the Greatsword can give us a little bit of insight into what and who these guys were. Bloodstained Greatsword, wielded by one of the Watchdogs of Farron, which was one of the people who preside over the slumber of fallen warriors. The blade is a reminder of the exile's past misdeeds. Inhuman strength is required to wield this heaviest of curved greatswords. Wow. So the Watchdogs of Farron is a thing. Oh, there's a bonfire. Where is there a bonfire? Is it down the steps? Is it over here? That would be a great place to end. Are you a bonfire? Hey, you're a gate. Does this gate open? No, of course it doesn't open. Why would it open? Okay, bonfire, bonfire, bonfire. Gives us a good ending spot. Wah! Yes. Yes, 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 yes. All right, let's rest here. I just want to see, before we end, I just want to see. I'm going to go back up here. I'm going to put an ember back on myself. And I'm just going to see if somebody else shows up. And if they're wearing the same headdress, if they got some crazy weapon, then I don't know. Then I guess I'll just complain about it more. Oh, Okay, so Yellowfinger Hazel was the same guy that we got before. But now it's just he and I. Oh god, I can't tell. It's gotta be just somebody trolling him. Let's see how he moves and how he reacts. This is a social experiment. I hear it. There he is. It's a less than impressive display when you get up close to him. Nope. So this, I don't know if this is a player. It can't be a player then. There's no way that they would... Oh no. Oh, I hit the wall. No, this isn't a player. This is just a super aggressive NPC. Come here. Oh. Yeah, see? The Xanthus crown and a pick. That's just a computer player. Oh, he's making such a huge deal about it. Oh, no. Alright, well, let's look at it, because it's still pretty cool. The Xanthus crown, supposedly made in imitation of a divine creature of Ulasil, a land of ancient golden sorceries. Xanthus clothing is the mark of the researcher of lost sorceries. The oversized crown is emblematic of their work. Such a curious pursuit, surely... is nothing to be ashamed of. I actually think that's from Demon Souls. I think that same crown you get from one of the bosses in Demon Souls. Ulasil. Or maybe that's in Dark Souls. Boy, I don't know. The Hazel pick. 19 sorcery. Choice weapon of Yellowfinger Hazel, a finger of Rosaria and Xanthus Scholar. This weapon is both a weapon and a sorcery staff. The gold specs remnants of lost sorcery. Steady chant. Okay, well. Maybe I was just complaining. This will be just an episode of me complaining, and I take that unto my bosom. Thank you guys so much for watching. We've got a couple more. I might take a little break and stretch, look at something else, try to relax a little bit. It was nerve-wracking. It was super fun, but it was nerve-wracking. So, from Digital Flashfire, I'm RT. Thank you guys so much for watching. See you in the next one.